breastfeeding has many different feels. At the beginning, when you're trying to get the baby to latch on, that can be painful. When your milk comes in and you're engorged, that can be painful. But when the letdown comes and your milk is actually flowing, then that's soothing. I was actually knocked out. I felt like somebody had given me, you know, some kind of knockout drug. And I know that there are natural hormones that are released, and they worked on me. So when the baby would nurse, there were plenty of times when I would just doze off because I was so relaxed.
I think that I know that Mozzie has bonded with me because there's a lot of eye contact between she and I when she's in my arms and I'm breastfeeding her. A lot of times I sing to her. I just sing her name over and over again, or I sing some other song that comes to my head. And, you know, she sees me and she smiles and she knows, you know, who I am. She knows my voice, and I'm pretty sure she also knows my smell because of the breast milk. She knows that's mom, and that's where I get my source of energy from.
Carmeni, Mozzie Carmeni, Mozzie Carmeni.
I delighted in the fact that she was, when she breastfed, she was still attached to me. So there was, again, this unity, this seamless bond. You know, as a woman of words, I'm rarely without them and unable to come up with them. But it really is kind of one of those things that's kind of hard to describe because it's so, it feels really sacred. And it feels really as though you're standing at the core of what it means to be human.
I do pump my breast milk when I'm not going to be around the baby, or if she's fallen asleep and she misses a feeding, then I need to pump my breast. Because what happens is you get engorged and you feel like your breasts are about to pop because you have, they're so full of milk. And the only way I can get relief from having so much milk is to actually pump the milk, and then I just store it so that I can feed it to her at another time. In the first few weeks of life, I really had to pump to build up the milk, and in the first few weeks of life, you have to feed them pretty much every 2 or 3 hours. So I would have to wake up and pump, and that was really hard. And I would pump in the bathroom. I would pump on the toilets. You know, I'd be sitting there like half asleep anyway. And I'd just be pumping, 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 pumping.
The thing that has helped me, I think, cope the most with motherhood is to integrate the baby into my life as much as me into hers. So when it was time for me to breastfeed, I don't think I did anything special. I just, wherever I was, I just did it.
A lot of the people I know have parents who came from the old country or from, you know, out of the United States. And to come into the United States, it was being a modern woman. And to be a modern woman, you used formula. You didn't do what your parents did because that was old fashioned. It wasn't necessarily that they couldn't breastfeed, it's just they didn't want to because it was not the modern thing to do. You want to be up with the times and you want to have to be able to go out and do things. then you used formula more.
I feel lonely when I nurse sometimes. Not all the time, but usually in the middle of the night. And that's only because, oh, probably because I'm tired, but also just because knowing that I am the only person that can nurse him, that I can, you know, but especially when he's upset, and sometimes when the baby's upset, you know, the one and only thing that's going to calm him down is to latch him on and let him nurse a little bit. And in a way, it's a good thing, and it makes you feel really good about yourself. And then in a way, it also makes you feel, at least for me, it makes me feel lonely, because I do feel like I'm the only one.